Allez, on y va. Bonjour, bonjour, bonjour. J'espère que vous allez bien. So I hope you're doing fine. So as usual, I will say hello to everybody. Of course, today will be, well, beginner levels, beginner intermediate. So basically it means that I will mostly speak English. And then, of course, the exercises will be in French. D'accord? So don't be shy, participate. And if you want to ask some questions, it's always possible as long as it doesn't really disturb the pace of the lesson. And one big thing, as you can see on your screen now, in 12 days, the channel will have a birthday, joyeux anniversaire, because it will turn 14 years old. It's quite old. Hein? Alors, Shahi est là. Bonjour, bonjour. Andrea est avec nous. Luciana est là. So you're chatting. Shahi, well, I said it already. Stardust est là. How many fingers, Stardust? I'm pretty sure that you've got one more during the weekend, probably. Let's be positive. Allez, who else? Dark Tainer is here. Chrismo, bonjour. Victoria Posse, coucou. Sinon, Aîné Winifred est là aussi. Daniela Belen, bonjour. Ça va bien, merci. Et vous? MLM19 est là aussi. Omar est avec nous. Yossi également. Chrismo dit, je voudrais aller à Paris et acheter un café pour Vincent. Mais je ne pense pas qu'il peut faire ça. Oui, non, pour l'instant, c'est difficile. C'est difficile d'aller à Paris. Cosmina est là aussi. Gloria est avec nous. Qui est-ce qu'il y a d'autre? Alors attendez, j'essaye de regarder. Ashwati est là, bonjour. Mamoham est avec nous. Mamaraz nous dit bonjour. Hi to you. Prasad est là, Cassandra est là. Cheryline, bonne nuit. Desarlika, Hilary Owell est là aussi. Vouslat et Stardust. Still 5, but it's okay. It was 3 and 2. That's what you say, if I remember. Allez, well, let's be positive. On est positif. Et s'il vous plaît, n'oubliez pas. This is the... This is the proper one. This is the one that you should look at right now. And don't forget to click on the like. My goal is, as usual, trying to reach 100 likes, I mean, during this lesson. It would be really, really great. Allez, la question du jour, so the question of the day. And because the channel will soon turn 14 years old, in that case, I would just wanted to ask you, il y a 14 ans, que faisiez-vous? So 14 years ago, what were you doing? Do you remember? Il y a 14 ans, que faisiez-vous? So obviously, I would like you to write me a beautiful sentence. Try to put the sentence in the past. Merci. Alors, Louisa Zamora is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. Stardust is agreeing on the 3 and 2. It will be okay, Stardust. You need to be, let's be positive. Otherwise, we don't have anything left. Rock is joining us. Prasad, joyeux Saint-Valentin. C'était hier. It was yesterday, I guess. Julia, some disco is happening in the background. Yeah, I've got a new light. Wanted to try it. I am not sure if it's nice or not. I will check it after, but it was funny to install it. Claudia, bonjour. Allez, write me a sentence. And Obura is with us too. Alors, Andrea is the first one to write. Be careful, Andrea, because the idea would be to put that in the past. D'accord? So what you've been using is the verb aller, and you've been putting that in the conditionnel présent. So it's not really the proper tense. You should put aller in the imparfait. Hein? So j'allais, remember? So it will be written A-L-L-A-I-S. Hein? J'allais à l'école primaire. Au Boura, j'étais à l'école primaire. Gordon, il y a 14 ans, j'ai oublié le jour dernier. Ah, petit problème de mémoire. Hein? Moi aussi. Moi, c'est l'âge. Cosmina, il y a 14 ans, j'étais plus jeune et belle que maintenant. Oh là là, bah, oui. Dark Tainer, j'étais, je regardais la télévision. Okay. Chrismo, je ne me souviens pas. Il y a 14 ans, qu'est-ce qu'on faisait? Ashwati, j'étudiais. Hein? Maybe you should put the verb étudier, but just in the imparfait form. So j'étudiais would be enough. So I've got the feeling that it was lasting in the past. And this is the idea of the imparfait. Shahi, quand j'étais petite, je suis allée à l'école. Très bien. Daniela, ma première année d'université. Ah, très bien. Gloria, je venais d'avoir un smartphone. Eh oui, c'est vrai, c'est vrai, c'est fou. Hillary qui nous dit « J'étais moins vieille il y a 14 ans. » Tout le monde. Et c'est la beauté de la chose. Il y a 14 ans, nous étions plus jeunes. Hein? Andrea, merci, je vous en prie. Julia, il y a 14 ans, quand j'ai quitté le métier de la traductrice, je me suis concentrée sur le travail de technicienne. Yann Arte, il y a 14 ans, j'écoutais les médias, d'accord? Stardust, il y a 14 ans, j'étais au Royaume-Uni et je m'y suis fait des amis qui ont duré. Jusqu'à aujourd'hui. Au début, j'ai eu des difficultés à comprendre l'anglais britannique. Mais après un certain temps, ça s'est bien passé. Très bien. Claudia, il y a 14 ans, j'étais en études d'italien. D'accord. Denora, j'ai commencé mon travail à San Francisco. Prasad, comment parler français? Je suis un débutant, toujours incapable de former des phrases. So Prasad, the best way to learn how to structure sentences, if you really want to structure sentences, which is normally what you want when you learn a language, you need to go through the grammar. You need to really understand how to structure and how to build the sentences. Obviously, at the same time, you want to make sure that you pronounce properly. So phonetics is always good. After that, vocabulary. But this is the idea. The idea is to try to start first with the grammar, with everything at the same time. But this is the only way, Prasad. Look at my videos. Omar, il y a 14 ans, je travaillais à un projet dans un pays d'Amérique du Sud. Cassandra, il y a 14 ans, j'étais à l'université en deuxième année. Luciana qui nous dit, je travaillais beaucoup à l'hôpital, des cliniques et mes parents habitaient chez moi. Yossi, je travaillais comme toujours. Yossi est un travailleur. Mamaraz, je me suis marié. Bah, félicitations. Vouslat, je m'amusais beaucoup. Victoria Possé, il y a 14 ans, je travaillais et j'espérais apprendre le français. Et maintenant, Victoria Possé. Et voilà, Victoria Possé a réussi à atteindre son rêve. Victoria parle, écrit, comprend le français, je dis bravo. Cheryline, j'étais à l'école primaire, concourant pour les médailles dans divers concours académiques, danse, art, etc. Renato Silva nous dit bonsoir et nous disons bonsoir à Renato. Alors, souvenez-vous, remember that we've been starting that, well, few days, few weeks ago. I've been receiving two things, but I thought that I would wait that for tomorrow or the day after. So it was from Cosmina, if I remember properly, and Denora. So you've been sending me the things. Don't worry, I received them. We will do that tomorrow because I thought that it might be more appropriate for the level. Alors, à vos téléphones, if you want, like Denora, like Julia, like everybody, I guess, but you can still send them. Send me a picture, write me a little text, and after that I will include that in the lessons, and then we'll make an exercise based on your picture and your text. So I think it's really nice, and the pictures are really great, and your text too, so it's possible. Send it to vosphotos@fluent2plus.com, and then after that I will, as I said, include them in the lesson that we will have. Allez, the word of the day, le mot du jour. But then, well, more precisely, I would like you to get me or to give me a word that would sum up your weekend, maybe, and not your day, just to change a bit. Merci. Alors, c'est Chris Mo qui commence, et qui dit frisson. Cosmina qui bien sûr, toujours ubiquitaire. Les personnes vont avoir peur quand ils voient vos mots, Cosmina. Ça fait peur aux gens. Cheryline qui nous dit synchronicité. Gordon qui nous dit romantique. Mohana qui nous dit amusant. D'accord. Desarlika, pas comme j'ai espéré. Ça, c'est le problème. Il ne faut jamais attendre quoi que ce soit de la vie. Yulia qui nous dit une recherche. Vouslat, tranquille. Yossi qui nous dit intéressant. Luciana, festival de cinéma japonais. Comment ça, Luciana? Les cinémas sont ouverts? Ça, c'est incroyable. Renato, ou alors est-ce que c'est un festival en ligne, peut-être? Renato qui nous dit soleil et sans travail. Daniela qui m'offre un café virtuel. C'est pas grave, ne vous inquiétez pas, j'ai ma boisson caféinée ici, ça me suffit. Merci beaucoup, Daniela. Stardust qui dit tout le week-end, de haut en bas. Moi aussi, c'est les montagnes russes. Hillary qui nous dit « relaxé ». Andrea qui nous dit « très froid ». Alors Jeff qui nous dit « il neige beaucoup ». D'accord. Dark Tainer, « très relaxé ». Ça, c'est pas mal. Donc plutôt détendu. Denora, « faire du vélo dans la pluie ». Biliana qui nous dit « bonjour ». Bonjour Biliana, participez s'il vous plaît. Victoria Posse, « marcher ». Shahi qui nous dit « extravagant ». Waouh. Alors là, on voudrait des détails. Est-ce que là, extravagant, c'est intéressant? Omar, rééducation. Pour le dos. Omar, ça, c'est le tennis. Alors attention, Omar, le tennis, c'est pas bon pour le dos, hein, si vous avez mal au dos. Luciana, festival en ligne, d'accord, ouais. C'est dommage. Hein. Oh, c'est sympa les festivals de cinéma, moi j'adore. Daniela, pause. Ice Cubes, bonsoir Ice Cubes. Un petit mot s'il vous plaît. Gloria qui nous dit j'ai marché. Et Ice Cubes, pardon, qui nous dit neige. Et tout le monde se souvient, everybody remembers that Ice Cube is doing some incredible personnages, des bonhommes de neige qui ressemblent à des lapins. Alors attendez, attendez, parce que ça continue. Ça continue, ça continue. Une petite seconde. Donc, Yann Arte qui nous dit étonné, d'accord. Ashwati qui nous dit triste. Oh, qu'est-ce qui se passe, Ashwati? Qu'est-ce qui se passe? Il faut essayer d'être. C'est difficile parfois. La vie est difficile. Cassandra, célébration, la nouvelle année lunaire. Rock qui nous dit qu'il a marché. Et puis Sherilyn qui dit bonsoir à Ice Cube parce que nous sommes très polis ici. Allez, petit exercice de traduction. So in this exercise, I'm expecting you to translate the verbs. D'accord? As usual, so this is a classic that normally we do at this level for the beginners. So it should not be really difficult. I wanted to pick obviously some extremely useful verbs and verbs that normally you will see, quite fast when you learn the language. The first one, to say, how could you translate to say in French? Alors, je regarde, I'm looking at your answers, and so far, so good. So we agree that it should be dire. Dire, verb from the third group, so it can be a bit tricky to conjugate, but then we'll see that a bit later. So this is dire. Number two, numéro deux. Numéro deux, how could you translate this one to get? Alors là, c'est intéressant, c'est intéressant. I'm not really sure, so let's see. As I said, I mean, during these exercises, I will give you some translations. In my case, I was going for two verbs. Mohana went for the first one, recevoir. Julia went for the second one, obtenir. Prendre, it's more like to take. So to get, you don't really have this active concept. So basically, you get something, you receive something. So recevoir or then obtenir would probably be the best options. I'm looking at the others, but so far, no. Yeah, Desarlika, recevoir, oui. Prendre, because it's more active. Hein. You are doing it, you're taking something. Voilà. Alors, recevoir, obtenir, these two verbs are also from the third group, so they can be a bit tricky to conjugate. But we'll see that a bit later, obviously. Numéro 3. Numéro 3, so it's a classic, this one. Normally, you should know it. What is to know? Alors, it's starting, so oui, pas de problème. I would be a bit like Cosmina, or then Hilary, or then Omar too, so Julia too. Well, you can have the two options. Remember that in fact, un savoir and connaître can be used to express this to know concept. The difference between the two is mostly grammatical, in fact, because one of them will require a verb or a structure after and not the other. So, but this is something that we'll have the time to work on a bit later. So, savoir and connaître. And same thing here, as you can see, the two verbs belong to the third group. So, it's a bit tricky to conjugate. Numéro 4, this one should be extremely, extremely simple, at least I hope. Allez-y, what is to think in French? Alors oui, pas de problème. Hein. So I was going in the same direction. Oui, Ice Cube is giving réfléchir, why not, penser, réfléchir, depends on the context. Hein. In most of the cases, penser might be the first option that we would take, but then réfléchir, in some cases, will be totally correct. D'accord? So to think, penser, or then réfléchir, as Mohana and Ice Cubes were offering. Allez, numéro 5, how do you say to take in French? Ouais, voilà, hein. Donc là on est d'accord que ici c'est vraiment prendre, apporter Tammy would be more like to bring something, apporter quelque chose. So it's slightly different, and in that situation to take it's really really prendre, hein. D'accord, third group again, remember that, and this one can be a bit tricky because it has what we say three roots when you conjugate it. Numéro 6, how could you translate to see into French? Voilà, donc oui, to see, hein, would be voir. Alors, Hillary goes for the regarder, and it's true that it's in some cases it's a bit strange because we tend to use voir and regarder a bit, in the same way. We tend to think that regarder involves more attention. So you're proactive when you are using regarder. Regarder would be to watch, and then voir would be to see. But it's true, you're totally correct, Hilary, that in some cases we tend to use them in a blurry way. So voir would be the first one, and then in some cases we can use regarder as well. Numéro 7, regardez, oh, this one should be okay, I guess. Huh? Alors, ouais, d'accord, donc là, pas de problème. Hein. Venir is really the translation, straight translation of to come. Same thing here, verb from the third group, and same here, it can be quite tricky, because when you conjugate, especially in the present tense, after that, in most of the cases, they're not really, really difficult. Numéro 8, same thing here. I mean, you should know it at this level, at least I hope. We'll be right back. Alors là, oui, un classique. Hein. C'est un classique, c'est le verbe vouloir. Vouloir, same thing here. Third group can be tricky to conjugate. Present. Je veux, tu veux, il, elle veut, nous voulons. So second stem. Vous voulez. And then ils veulent. Third stem. So these verbs belong to these third stem verbs, especially in the present. After that, it's not really tricky. Allez, numéro 9, to use. How could you translate to use into French? Alors, to use, oui, d'accord, you see, what do you want to express with the M after, you see, utiliser, je ne sais pas ce que c'est. Okay, so, in my case, I wanted to offer you two options. The first one, obviously, like you wrote, it's utiliser. Utiliser is the first one, so it's not a problem. Shahi, oui, d'accord, très bien, you've been offering vouloir after, but I guess it was a mistake. The other option would be se servir de. Remember, se servir de, so in that case, it's a pronominal verb, so je me sers de, and then something. Hein. D'accord, so it would be, you've got the two options. The first one, utiliser, might be the best option, because it's a regular verb from the first group, and you don't need to add any preposition, not preposition, but pronouns before, if you want to use it like that, j'utilise, un stylo, d'accord? So, utiliser, or then se servir de. Allez, numéro 10, qu'est-ce que c'est? To give. So, how could you say to give into French? And Victoria Jacques is joining us. Bonjour Victoria, comment ça va? You've been sleeping, she's been sleeping too long, and it's a good sign. It's always a good sign when people sleep a long time. Allez, 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 oui, hein. So in that case, it's a classic one, it's donner, donner would be the best one, donner, regular verb, first group, it's not really tricky to conjugate, and even in the other tenses, it will be quite simple, so merci beaucoup. Keep in mind this list, because the same list will come a bit later, and of course we'll do something different with them, hein. So don't forget to click if you didn't do it already, because as you probably know, or if you don't know, I will explain to you, I would like to reach at least 100 likes for this lesson. Merci. Allez, the classic, it's the best place, c'est le meilleur endroit pour imaginer la suite, c'est le meilleur endroit pour. Julia, Vincent, peut-être que votre maîtresse d'école est fière de voir comment vous avez maîtrisé la conjugaison. Mais peut-être que ma maîtresse d'école n'est plus là. Parce que Vincent n'est pas jeune. Je ne suis pas un jeune homme. Alors, Olga Roule, pardon, Olga Ruiz qui nous rejoint. Bonjour, pas de problème si vous êtes en retard. So she's telling us that it's possible that she will be without Wi-Fi for some time soon. Well, we will be waiting for you. We are here, no stress. Alors, Dark Tainer est le premier, nous dit, c'est le meilleur endroit pour la marche, d'accord? Denora qui nous dit, c'est le meilleur endroit pour construire un château. Albuga is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour Albuga. Wolf, continue the sentence, Albuga. C'est le meilleur endroit pour, I mean, you know the exercise. Vuslat, c'est le meilleur endroit pour passer des vacances. Julia qui nous dit, c'est le meilleur endroit pour regarder les montagnes, c'est vrai. Andrea, c'est le meilleur endroit pour faire une semaine verte. Yann Arte, c'est le meilleur endroit pour skier. Hillary qui nous dit, c'est le meilleur endroit pour faire du camping. Eh oui. Laura, c'est le meilleur endroit pour faire du yodel. Oh là là, eh ouh. Eh oui. Et puis il y a aussi les grosses trompes là. Vicky, c'est le meilleur endroit pour passer les vacances. Stardust. Moi, j'ai pensé à la même chose. C'est le meilleur endroit pour être seul. Alors, je ne sais pas si c'est une chose positive ou négative, c'est autre chose. Yossi, c'est le meilleur endroit pour passer des vacances et admirer le paysage. Luciana, c'est le meilleur endroit pour réfléchir sur la vie et les beautés de la nature. Ça, c'est vrai. Biliana, c'est le meilleur endroit pour la joie, pour être heureuse, peut-être. Victoria Possé, c'est le meilleur endroit pour passer une journée d'excursion, c'est vrai. Ashwati, c'est le meilleur endroit pour les vacances. Daniela, c'est le meilleur endroit pour marcher. Albuga, c'est le meilleur endroit pour faire une randonnée. Oui, vous avez corrigé, c'est bien. Gordon, c'est le meilleur endroit pour marcher, prendre des photos, pluriel, hein, et finalement se reposer un long temps, d'accord, oui, ou se reposer longtemps, hein, utiliser l'adverbe. Ice Cube, c'est le meilleur endroit pour admirer la beauté de la nature. Omar, c'est le meilleur endroit pour être un week-end relaxé. Rock, c'est le meilleur endroit pour faire de la pêche. Eh oui, c'est vrai, il y a une rivière. Riena, c'est le meilleur endroit pour faire une randonnée. Cosmina, c'est le meilleur endroit pour pouvoir respirer, se sentir libre comme un oiseau, pour se nettoyer de tout ce qui est toxique. Comment ça se passe, Cosmina? C'est comme ça, c'est avec une brosse? Est-ce qu'on se brosse pour retirer toute la toxicité, je ne sais pas. Gloria, c'est le meilleur endroit pour, ouais, avoir ou prendre l'air. Stardust qui nous dit qu'être seul, pas de problème. Cheryline, c'est le meilleur endroit pour jouer un personnage dans un jeu où vous devez construire une civilisation à partir de zéro. Ça, c'est vrai. C'est vrai que c'est bon. Là, vous pouvez construire tout ce que vous voulez. Merci. Allez, si on va chercher des noms, pas de verbes, mais des noms. Oh, je me demande si j'ai fait... Attendez. Oh oui. Une petite seconde. Et là, vous remarquez le professionnalisme de... Voilà. Allez, on va faire des noms. Est-ce qu'il y a un fantôme derrière Vincent? Non, Omar, Julia... Julia made fun of me. But then, Omar, it's the same. No ghost. It's just, I wanted to try a light just to see how it goes. And I think it's fun. I think it looks quite interesting. So, il y a quelque chose de corps derrière moi. I've been traumatized, Ice Cube, remember. I have been traumatized with this door that can open like that. So, it's not a person. It's just... Non, c'est mon ami. Voilà. Allez, please now, find a noun that starts with a. Alors, excusez-moi, je faisais les modifications. Cosmina, un engramme, Albuga, échange. Échange masculin, hein, échange, un échange. Darktainer, escargot, oui, singulier, un escargot, so it's a masculine word. Cherylin, une espérance. Gordon, une éléphante. Gloria, un éléphant. Denora, écoutez. Be careful, Denora. I wanted to have a noun. I didn't want to have a verb in that case. So it would be just to change a bit. We had the verbs last week, so now we're getting some nouns. Alors attendez, c'était qui? Ah non, c'était... Oui. Rock. Oui, c'était une école. Julia, elle. Oui, mais c'est pas... It's not a noun, it's a pronoun in that case, Julia. Yossi, un élève. Yanarte, l'eau. Oui. Remember, by the way, that O is a feminine word. In most of the cases, people don't really remember whether it's masculine or feminine, but it's une O. It's a feminine word. Luciana, des écouteurs, peut-être. Julia. Ah, Julia qui donne un autre. Un escargot, oui. And one day I will sing you the song Petit escargot porte sur son... And the rest. It's a nice song. Michael, l'éléphant, masculin. Laura, été, masculin, un été. Andrea, enchanté. Yeah, be careful, Andrea, enchanté. It's, well, you got two options, whether it's past participle, or then it can be an adjective. So in that case, we were looking for nouns, d'accord? So substantive, as you can call. Let me see. Chrismo, une église, une entreprise, des enfants, un ingénieur. Be careful, ingénieur, Chrismo, it starts with E. Biliana, écoutez, same thing, Biliana, try to give me a noun. Tammy, une église. Cassandra, une erreur. Remember, Cassandra, erreur, it's not O, but it will be E-U, erreur. Omar, une étoile. Stardust, un émeu, l'animal. Victoria Possé, un endroit. Olga Ruiz, d'accord, pas de problème. Evelyne, prendre. Evelyne, no. You want to give only verbs and I say no. I say no, please give me some nouns. Shahi, c'est vraiment un joli endroit. Oh, Shahi, you need to refresh. Desarlika, une écharpe. Ice Cubes, une expérience. Be careful, experiment. It's in English, it's not in French. And then Daniela, un endroit. Rihanna, une école. Et Albuga, une erreur. Vous corrigez, merci. Allez, numéro 2, number 2, and then please write me a noun that starts with N. A noun, please put the article, whether it's masculine or feminine, un ou une. Soso Yoso is joining us. Bonsoir. Alors, ça commence aussi la nuit, très bien. Vous slate une nourriture. Andrea, nez, donc c'est masculin, un nez. Julia, un nuage. Oui. Hilary, nuit, be careful here. Hilary, nuit, it's feminine. Une nuit. Desarlika, la neige. Yanarte, un nom. Chrismo, Noël. Cosmina Bellouf, la nidrescence. Cosmina, il faut mettre des mots que les gens comprennent aussi. Cosmina, que se passe-t-il? Albuga, le niveau. Daniela, la nourriture. Stardust, la nuit. Sosoyoso, la nuit aussi. Denora, la nationale. Ah, this is interesting. So, national, it's an adjective. But then it's true that you can use that for the main roads in France. So, in that case, la nationale, you should put E in the end. And in that case, it's totally correct, but you are only talking about this main road that will go from one city to another city, la nationale. Darktainer, la noisette, only one S, hein, and it's feminine. Luciana, le nuage, Biliana, négligé. Be careful, Biliana, the idea is to put some nouns, not verbs, please. Julia, une nounou. Rock. Alors, une ou la neige, oui. Albuga, une noix. Tammy, le nez. Evelyn, vouloir. Be careful, Evelyn. I would not like to have verbs, d'accord? And it doesn't start with N, by the way. Evelyn, refresh your stream, refresh the page. I think we're not really synchronized. Victoria possède une nouvelle. Gordon, la neige. Daniela, noir. Well, in that case, it's an adjective, so probably you would like to go for the nouns. Michael, la neige aussi. Laura, la noix. Gloria, not... I want to trick me. You want to put some verbs. You try. Everybody's trying to put some verbs. Namaraz, le nez. Riena, la naissance féminine. Shahi, la neige, très bien. La nuit aussi. Ice cubes, nourriture. Oh, such a surprise! Ice Cube is talking about nourriture! Féminin, très bien. Soso Yoso, la nuit, Stardust, une narration, très bien. Ok, Gordon qui dit N, impossible. It's okay. Now you've got a list. You've got a list. This is the idea of the exercise, so you can follow and look at the words. Albuga, un noyau. Chariche, un nid. Cassandra, Noël. Et puis Ashwati, nourriture. Allez, it's the last one of this series, so please write me a noun, not a verb, or then don't put an adjective, put a noun, please. Starts with a P, d'accord. Stella Pashova is joining us. Coucou Stella, I hope you're doing fine. So today it's for beginners, so it means that I will speak French and English. Hein? On y va. Alors, ça y est, Darktainer is the first one. Piano, masculin, très bien. Dessarlika, poisson, masculin, un poisson, très bien. Vouslat, une piscine, très bien. Gordon, un poisson. Yossi, une puissance. Albuga, un pouce. Yeah, be careful, Albuga, un pouce, if you're talking about this finger. In that case, it's masculine, I remember. Un pouce. Cosmina, la plume et le pétrichor. C'est pétrichor ou pétrichor? Je ne sais pas ce qu'est ce mot. I don't know this word. Pétrichor, pétrichor. I would tend to pronounce cor. Luciana, le parfum. Albuga, une puce aussi. Andrea, la palme. Yeah, be careful, it's feminine. Hein. La palme. Chrismo, alors Paris. Le pain, d'accord. The rest, it's a verb. Hilary, un pied. Très bien. Daniela, Paris. JW, un poulet. It's always nice. A chicken. Cote pour le poulet. Ou un poulet que vous mangez, bien sûr. Ice cubes, un prolétaire. Ou une prolétaire, masculin ou féminin. Rock, une poêle. Oui. Yann Arte qui nous dit polar. Oui, qu'est-ce que vous voulez dire avec Paula? Laura, une poupette ou une poupée. Denora, un président. Tammy, la cuisine. Qu'est-ce que c'est, Tammy, la cuisine? Est-ce que c'est la cuisine? And then you modified it. Julia, les poches. Eh oui, on peut mettre beaucoup de choses dans les poches. Biliana, un parapluie, comme les parapluies de Cherbourg. Daniela, un pain. Shahi, la pluie, le pied. Très bien. Albuga, un pipi. Que se passe-t-il, Albouga? Que se passe-t-il? Rihanna, la pneumonie, Shahi du pain. Victoria possède un perroquet. Eh oui. Michael, la poste. Be careful, it's feminine. Hein? La poste. Oh, then it depends. Are you talking about the institution? So the postal office, la poste, or then if it's a vacancy, in that case it's un poste. Hein? In a firm, for instance, you would like to apply for a vacancy, so it's un poste. Olga, paquet masculin, Soso Yoso des pupitres, Cassandra la piscine, Stardust la poursuite, Gloria la pomme, ça c'est pas mal. Yann Arte la politique, Daniela le papillon. Eh oui. Ice Cubes, la pâte. Alors, it's interesting because Ice Cubes, when you're putting this word, la pâte, it means the dough. So you can talk about une tarte or a pie or something like that. If you really want to talk about the pasta, because we both know that you're coming from this incredible place where, I mean, the pasta is like a religion. In that case, you should put that, in most of the cases, in the plural form. Les pâtes will be the pasta. D'accord? Cheryline, polymérase. Everybody is getting... I mean, you know, whether it's... Cheryline, Oden Cosmina, I'm pretty sure that I will have some words at least with three syllables and nobody will get them. Albouga, un poisson. Victoria, Jacques, une pâtisserie. Très bien, merci beaucoup. Alors, albouga, une pâte d'eau, les pâtes pasta. Oui, oui. To make it simple, let's agree to make it simple. Yes, this is like that. Allez, Cletinho da Silva is joining us. Coucou, coucou, you just arrive for the numbers of the day. So remember, number of the day. And then Cosmina is just like, she's giving the translations now. Not the translations, the definitions. So merci beaucoup, Cosmina, pour les définitions. Alors, numéro 1, remember that I will read them twice. The first one will be simple because it will be only one digit and will continue until I'm not sure if it's 5 or 6 for this level. So 3 please write it. Alors, pour l'instant, je dis, oups, bravo. Oui, effectivement, hein, so this one was, I guess, not really tricky, so it's 3, like that. JW wanted to write it with the letters, so it's obviously T-R-O-I-S. Très, très bien. Be careful, Shahi, it was not 23, hein, so we've got only one digit. It was my mistake, maybe it was not clear. Now we are entering the 2-digit world, so... The number will have 2 digits, d'accord? So I will read it twice. 12. 12. Alors, ouais, c'est très très bien, félicitations. 12, Julia, she's writing that in a strange manner. 12, I mean, first, I mean, in French, when you add so many O's in a row, it's you don't pronounce it like ooh. Hein. It's not like in English, so it would be 12. Alors, in that case, it's 12 and 12, well, everybody had it perfectly, so it's 1 and 2. 1 et 2, c'est 12. Allez, numéro 3. Numéro 3, so obviously, as you can see, we'll have 3 digits. Attention, I will read it twice. 390. 390. Please write it. Alors, Yurav is joining us. Hi, Yurav. How are you? I mean, we're doing a dictation now with the number, so try to participate because it would be really, really great. And don't forget to click on the like. It's your way to thank me for these little things that I'm doing for you. Alors, 390. Let's look at that. Yep, you're extremely good. Félicitations. I am so proud of you. I mean, now, I mean, it's like, it's really, really great. So, 390. 390 390 390. Be careful, Rock. You were a bit far from it, but it's okay. Don't worry. We're doing this exercise daily, so you can participate again and again. And trust me, you will be like the others. You will progress quite fast. Allez, numéro 4. Le numéro 4, as you can see, well, we'll have 4 digits in that case. Attention, I will read it twice. 2145. 2145. Try to write it. Viva is joining us. Viva! Ça, c'est formidable comme nom. Viva, try to write the numbers. Alors, 2145, well, so far so good, I don't see any mistakes, in fact. So, 2145, 2, 1, 4, 5. So it will be 2, 1, 4, and 5. 2145. Let's have a look at the next one. Next one, as I told you, and it might be the last one, yes, from this series. So we'll have 5 digits. D'accord? Same thing here. Take your time. I will try to read it, I mean, quite slowly to make sure that everyone can listen to it and hear it. Attention, attention. 89 548. 89 548. Allez-y. Alors, je regarde. I'm looking at your things, and well, I must say that it's really good. Thank you, Yesero, for putting the the thing Vusla too, so it's easier for me. Be careful, ice cubes. You were not generous enough, ice cubes. What's going on? So it was quite close, obviously, because you wrote 148, but in fact, I was pronouncing 500. 148. 548. It's only the 5, 5, 5. And because I don't pronounce the k, remember, 5, but then after that, 500. I'm not pronouncing 500. D'accord? 548. 89548. I'm looking at Daria. Daria is joining us, so you can see her right there. Daria is nice, but then she wants to be really strict with the persons. Don't know why my camera is quite it's blurry now. So yeah, don't forget to listen to Daria and try to click. Otherwise, she will be upset. Merci beaucoup. Yossi, comment est-ce qu'on dit digit en français? On dit chiffre. That's the difference between un chiffre and then un nombre. D'accord? This is the difference. The main difference between the two. Un chiffre and then un nombre. But in some cases, people can mix them, and in some cases, they use the word chiffre instead of nombre. So, but this is the difference normally between the two. Un nombre will be at least deux chiffres. And this is the way it goes. I guess the camera wanted to be a bit lazy today. Allez, imaginez, it's the best person. It's the best person. Ah, sorry. Tammy, please pronounce 105. Okay. So, Tammy, it's just for you. This is only for Tammy Allison, because it's my pleasure. So remember, Tammy, if we make it... well, let's take the time to explain the thing. So the difference between the two. First, will be mostly based on the nasal. Remember the nasal, it's the sound that will go in your nose. So the nasal, usually you get it when you start to combine a vowel and the letter N. D'accord? We will see later that M is the same, but let's focus on N because this is in your example. So in that case, vowel and then N. So in your situation, you ask me two nasal. The first one, E, N. You combine the two and you get the sound en, 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 en. So the concept, Tammy, and this is the beauty about being a teacher, because you look stupid at one point when you start to explain the nasal. I will just press my nose and you will see that basically the sound will be totally different. So it means that the air is really going there. You see, it stays here. So really you need to put the air in your nose. First one, son, final T, not pronounced. Second one, the sound E and N together will give you un, 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 un. Same concept, it goes in the nose, un, you don't hear any N, okay? This one, Q, final Q is pronounced, so cinq. First one, cent, second one, cinq. So they're quite clear. First, the nasal is not the same, and then the cinq, you have this final k, but then of course when after that you combine it with another thing, the k won't be pronounced, d'accord? So you just rely on the nasal en un. Voilà, Tammy. I hope it was not too long. Sorry. Allez, try to imagine. C'est la meilleure personne. Pour, and of course it's not place in that case, as you can see, there are a few mistakes this time. Mm-hmm. So, and while you are typing your sentence, I just want to remind you politely that if you arrived, you didn't have the time to click on the like button, then it's the proper time now to do it. I would like to reach the 100 likes for this lesson, which I think could be possible. Allez-y. Alors, je regarde, c'est la meilleure personne pour... Alors Gordon qui nous dit un robbery, qu'est-ce que c'est un robbery? C'est un anglicisme. Don't even try. Alors Dark Tainer, c'est la meilleure personne pour chanter. Ice Cubes, summary, you're right. Ah, alors, summary of the language, you're right, but you don't pronounce. But yes. Yes, that's just the way it is, Ice Cubes, and it's not a new thing, you know it. Yes, Ero, c'est la meilleure personne pour vous montrer les fringues à la mode. Yulia, c'est la meilleure personne pour devenir un espion. Michael, c'est la meilleure personne pour travailler. Biliana, c'est la meilleure personne pour regarder le match. Rihanna, c'est la meilleure personne à éviter. Mais pourquoi? On ne sait pas. Ensuite, je regarde. Attendez, voilà. Daria, c'est la meilleure personne pour une publicité de vêtements sportifs. Stard, c'est la meilleure. Ah, c'est le meilleur endroit pour fumer une cigarette. C'était la personne Stardust, mais c'est pas grave. Manila, c'est la meilleure personne pour le travail. Daniela qui nous dit, c'est la meilleure personne pour être dans un magazine de mode. Andrea, c'est la meilleure... Oh! I'm not reading your thing, Andrea, you know that. Luciana, c'est la meilleure personne pour conduire un bateau sur une mer agitée. Yossi, c'est la meilleure personne pour vendre un masque. Peut-être. Yann Arte, c'est la meilleure personne pour devenir militaire. Hillary, c'est la meilleure personne pour dire bonjour. Victoria Possé, c'est la meilleure personne pour sa famille. Très bien. Denora, c'est la meilleure personne pour espionner. Est-ce qu'il a, il a une tête d'espion? Moi, je dis qu'il est très sérieux, cet homme. Cosmina, c'est la meilleure personne pour braquer une banque. C'est un braqueur à lunettes. Olga, c'est la meilleure personne pour aller en voyage. Cassandra, c'est la meilleure personne pour devenir un créateur de mode. Laura, c'est la meilleure personne pour faire de la musique rap. Vuslat, c'est la meilleure personne pour aller faire du sport. Ice Cube, c'est la meilleure personne pour me donner une belle offre comme un chocolat chaud. Ben oui, pourquoi pas, un bon chocolat chaud. Oh, Ice Cube, si vous allez à Paris, il faut sortir aussi. Il ne faut pas toujours être à l'intérieur. Si vous allez à Paris, allez dans ce café qui s'appelle Angelina et vous demandez un chocolat chaud. Oh, et alors là, c'est incroyable. Les chocolats chauds d'Angelina, c'est incroyable. Shahi, c'est la meilleure personne pour une publicité. Et Stardust, c'est la meilleure personne quand tu es de mauvaise humeur. Il a l'air si fâché. C'est vrai. Si vous êtes de mauvaise humeur, vous regardez des gens qui sont encore plus de mauvaise humeur et vous allez mieux. Allez, on va faire. Alors, vous savez quoi? Snoop Dogg est avec nous, mais c'est vraiment un chien. C'est quoi le thème de ce live? Nous faisons des exercices, monsieur Snoop Dogg, waf waf! Allez, let's translate some sentences now. So as usual, I will give you some sentences in English and then you try to translate them into French. Obviously, as usual, we've got different ways, so it's possible to negotiate. We'll see exactly what you will come up with and then I will give you one option, but it's not the only one. Alors oui, Ice Cube, ça. Angelina, vous en avez deux. Hein, vous en avez deux. L'original, il est à côté du Louvre, juste en face, sur Rivoli. Et le deuxième, un petit peu plus loin, si vous êtes dans le quartier latin, c'est à côté des jardins du Luxembourg, derrière, entre le Sénat et les jardins du Luxembourg. Alors, ça commence à arriver. Ça commence à arriver. Cosmina en première position. Dimanche, je suis allé au restaurant avec Nicolas, effectivement. Alors, donc, personnellement, je l'ai mis au masculin. So I've been putting the masculine form. I'm looking at your forms. Cassandra, in that case, I was an entertainer. I was hoping you to try to dance a bit with the verb aller in the passé composé form. It was the idea. The idea was to try to see how you could make it. Sabir is joining us. Bonjour Sabir, you can translate the sentence. The next one, obviously. Le dimanche, je suis allé au restaurant avec Nicolas, nous dit Snoop Dogg. C'est très bien écrit. Stardust, oui, très bien. Ok, so in that case, we agree that the verb, I mean, would be aller. I've been putting the masculine form, obviously, because I was talking about myself. But if you write it for you and you're a woman, you should definitely add the feminine at the end of your past participle aller with a in the end. The main thing that you need to remember is that the verb aller is using être as a helping verb. Je suis, d'accord, aller. Second thing, well, preposition will be à. But then remember, when you combine the preposition à with the article le, because restaurant is masculine, à le restaurant, it will become au restaurant. It doesn't happen with the article la. À la boulangerie. No problem. D'accord? But in that case, it should definitely be au. Dimanche, je suis allé au restaurant avec Nicolas. Remember that in French, we don't put any preposition before. So we don't say sur dimanche. We don't say I'm looking à dimanche. You don't put anything. You just start straight with dimanche. D'accord? If you say le dimanche, I understand that it's something that you will repeat regularly. So on Sundays, it means that it's like it's happening every Sunday. So be careful. In that case, I just wanted to mention last Sunday, so yesterday, dimanche. D'accord? Allez. Let's have a look at numéro 2. Numéro 2, ah pardon. Gordon, restaurant versus resto. Restaurant is the normal word. D'accord? Resto will be more spoken. So, one more time, Gordon, it's always good to know the two. But if you're not sure about the persons that you are talking to, and if you think that basically it's a bit more formal, go for the official one, le restaurant. D'accord? Le resto, it's a bit more relaxed. It's not really, a bit like spoken French. D'accord? But be careful. Be really careful. You can use the two, no problem at all. But be aware about the context. Numéro 2, we went for a walk in town. Allez-y. Alors, je regarde. Cosmina, nous sommes allés pour une randonnée dans la ville. Oui, nous avons fait une promenade en ville. Is offering Yesero and look. Cosmina, pas de problème. Nous sommes allés dans une randonnée. It's a bit, yeah. Randonnée, I've got the feeling that it's mostly, well, in the countryside maybe. Or maybe in the mountains, like the thing that you've been sending. It could be, I mean, it's okay. It's okay. It would not be the first one. Yesero, it's a good thing. Nous avons fait une promenade en ville. Pas de problème. Yossi, nous sommes allés nous promener. Remember, Yossi, you need to adapt the pronoun. Hein. Se promener, it's the infinitive, but it's really nous promener. Stardust, nous sommes allés nous promener en ville. Cheryline, nous sommes allés nous promener en ville. Oui. Stella, nous nous sommes promenés en ville. Good. Alors, be careful, because in that case, of course, if you write it like that, feminine plural, it means that it's a group of women, so no problem. Daniela, nous voulons marcher dans la ville. Oui, in that case, it would be like, we want to walk in town, in the city. It would be possible, but it's not really the concept in that case, and because I wanted one more time to try to work on the past. But it's okay. I mean, you've got the idea. After that, you can fine-tune it with the past. Riena, nous sommes allés nous promener en ville, d'accord. So, look. So, personally, I went for nous nous sommes promenés. So, the verb se promener. And then, obviously, I put that in the passé composé. Remember that the passé composé form of these reflexive verbs or pronominal verbs, it will always be constructed with the helping verb être. D'accord? So, nous, I mean, we need to have the second pronoun, sommes, so it's être, and then we put promener. Remember that because we are using être, in the end of promener, we should put, if it's the plural, s, if it's the feminine, if it's the feminine plural, es. D'accord? And then the other thing is en ville, I mean the preposition is en. If you want to go for dans la ville, I really have the feeling that you really want to say it's inside the city, and it's not really what we would use in this context. Allez, numéro 3. Numéro 3, Nicola was cold and wanted to go home, and it's true. It's true. Allez, let's try to be positive. Let's think that somehow it will be possible to reach 100 likes. I mean, we just need 9 persons. So if you just arrived, if you didn't yet click on the like, be nice, click on the like. Otherwise, I will be so sad, so sad. And you don't want that. You really don't want me to cry in front of you. It would be extremely embarrassing. Alors, let's have a look at your sentences. So in that situation, yes, I was expecting you to use the imparfait if you know how to use it. So, so far, so good. So the verb is avoir, I mean the expression is avoir froid. Avoir froid, remember, to be cold in French, it's to have cold. So avoir froid. So I am hoping you to put this avoir in the imparfait tense. The way it will go, the root will be ave, and then you will put your ending. The ending for the third person of the singular will be ait. Ave plus ait will give you avait. So this is the verb avoir in the imparfait tense. Nicolas avait froid. And obviously we continue in the imparfait. The verb is vouloir. Same thing here. The root will be voul, V-O-U-L. This is the root. And you put after that your ending A-I-T. Voulait. Nicolas avait froid et il voulait rentrer. D'accord? Allez. Well, so far, it's quite good, in fact. But the idea here was to try to dance with the imparfait. And remember that Julia, A-I-S, it will be for je and tu. Hein? It's not for il, elle. Numéro 4. Eh bien, regardez. He played with his friends and I filed documents. How could you say that in French? Alors, Charles Hyatt, I don't know what you want to say, Charles, because you've got some typos. It's not really clear, Charles. Gloria is writing froid, d'accord, très bien. Alors, Cosmina, il s'est joué avec ses copines, j'ai rangé les documents. So be careful, Cosmina, because the verb jouer, you don't really need to put any pronouns. In fact, it's jouer avec quelqu'un. So in that case, you don't really need to squeeze any pronoun. You want to make it reflexive? I don't really know. Alors, let's look. Cheryline, il a joué avec ses amis et j'ai déposé des documents. Yeah, in that case, I really wanted to go for ranger was good, Cosmina. Personally, I went for classer, which would be possible. Yossi, filé, maybe not filé. Julia, préparé could be acceptable, but it's not really préparé. You want to put them somewhere. Déposé, stardust, maybe not déposé in that case. I'm looking at the things that you're putting. Il voulait des amis. Oui, il jouait, Hilary, avec ses amis. D'accord. So in that situation, yes, the verb is jouer. I wanted to put that in the passé composé form. Il a joué. D'accord. Remember that jouer, in fact, is extremely regular. So it means that when you put that in the passé composé form, you just need to use avoir as a helping verb. Il a, present, joué. And then avec ses amis. Same thing for the verb classer. Classer, regular verb from the first group. So it will use avoir to. J'ai classé. J'ai rangé. J'ai préparé. Let's be. let's tolerate. J'ai fait ice cubes des documents. It's like I'm widening my spectrum. Alors, classer or then ranger would be the best option if that's okay with you. Numéro 5. Allez, we ate and did his homework. Allez-y. How could we say that in French? Ouh, non, j'aime pas celle-là. Alors, j'ai proposé à Nicolas de patiner, il a refusé. I can see that we are that close to the 100 likes. Please click if it's possible. Let's touch this 100. Alors, Cosmina, nous avons mangé et mon fils a fait ses devoirs. you don't know Nicolas. Hein? Nicolas needs to be surrounded, so I need to be involved in the devoir process, the homework process. So in that case, but of course, I mean, you could translate it like that. Cheryline, nous avons mangé et avons fait ses devoirs. Très bien. So remember that homework, in fact, in French, it's devoir, and it's in the plural form, des devoirs, les devoirs, ses devoirs. So Gordon, be careful, it's not in the singular form, and that's my point. Put that in the plural form. So if you say son devoir, it's like his duty. something that you need to do. And in most of the cases, it's something that you need to do maybe for your country or for the army or something like that. In that case, we're talking about homework. So it means that you will use the plural form, ses devoirs, mes devoirs, des devoirs. So the verb manger, manger, regular verb, it means that when you put manger in the passé composé, you will use avoir, d'accord? Nous avons, and then you put the past participle, manger, E accent aigu. Et nous avons fait, so the expression is faire les devoirs, faire ses devoirs, faire mes devoirs, but it's faire. So faire should be also, one more time, in the passé composé form. So you use avoir, nous avons, and then you put the past participle, fait, F-A-I-T. Nous avons mangé et nous avons fait ses devoirs. Shahi, she has a great look because she noticed that. Yeah! Ha! Finally, we reached the 100. Curiosidades is joining us. Don't forget to click. You might meet the 101 like. Merci beaucoup. Allez, c'est le... Ah oh mince, pardon. C'est le pire endroit. Ah ben voilà. It's the worst place. Just imagine. It's the worst place. C'est le pire endroit. Pourquoi? Ah ben voilà. Finally, it works. C'est le pire endroit pour imaginer. Alors, chère Eileen, is it grammatically incorrect to omit the same pronoun the second time? Non, not really. It depends. In most of the cases, if you can repeat it, it's not a problem. Nous sommes partis et avons fait du sport. It's possible to omit it, so no worries. Usually, I tend to, especially at this level, I tend to repeat it to make quite clear and to have some identifiable structures that you can identify. We'll make it. So this is the reason why I tend to repeat the pronouns. But if you want to drop them, drop. Alors, c'est Ice Cube qui commence et dit « C'est le pire endroit pour être seul. » Remember, Ice Cube, you should put « E » in the end if you're talking about yourself. But if you're talking about, I mean, generally, it should be, well, masculine, because masculine is the basic form. But it's up to you. « Yesero, c'est le pire endroit pour avoir un jardin. » Ça, c'est formidable, Yesero. Je dis vrai, c'est vrai, c'est vrai, planter c'est difficile de planter dans la mer, mais probablement possible, j'imagine. Cosmina, c'est le pire endroit pour avoir une querelle. Pourquoi? Alors pourquoi? On ne sait pas finalement. Regardons ensuite. Bassam qui nous dit, ok, bonjour Bassam, you can join the lesson. Gordon qui nous dit, c'est le pire endroit pour un grand orage. Yulia B, c'est le pire endroit pour atterrir en avion. Il y a des hydravions. Il y a des hydravions, ça existe. Yossi, c'est le pire endroit pour habiter tout au long de l'année. Stella, c'est le pire endroit pour étudier. Parce qu'on voudrait aller à la plage pour regarder le soleil se levant avec un café. Eh oui. Gloria, coucou Bassam. Gloria est très polie. Tammy, c'est le pire endroit pour faire... pour nager. Pourquoi, Tammy? C'est possible de nager. Olga, c'est le pire endroit pour un rendez-vous. Rock, pour une personne invalide ou un handicapé, c'est vrai que ça doit être compliqué. Hein, c'est vrai. Cosmina, je veux dire que le lieu est tellement beau que c'est dommage d'avoir une dispute. Ah, et vous savez ce que c'est. Parfois, le lieu n'influe pas sur la chimie entre les gens ou l'alchimie entre les gens. Evelyne, c'est le pire endroit pour travailler. Curiosidades, c'est le pire endroit pour penser que c'est le pire de quelque chose, car il faut penser au meilleur et non au pire. Oh, oui, mais on a parlé du meilleur. Curiosidades, you were not there at the beginning. We've been covering the it's the best place. So that's the reason why. I mean, the idea was to go in the worst place now. Shahi, c'est le pire endroit pour des vacances pour 2 ou 3 jours. Stardust, c'est le pire endroit où vous pouvez être quand un tsunami fait irruption sur vous. J'espère que vous avez encore la chance de boire votre verre comme ça. Denora, c'est le pire endroit pour le golf. C'est vrai. C'est vrai. Ensuite, Bouslat, c'est le pire endroit pour aller à l'école. Victoria, c'est le pire endroit pour faire le ménage. C'est vrai qu'il y a beaucoup de pièces. Et peut-être un peu de sable, je ne sais pas, qui vient de la plage. Yann Arte, c'est le pire endroit pour les vacances. D'accord. Hillary, c'est le pire endroit pour nettoyer des fenêtres. Ça, c'est vrai. Allez, I told you that we would work again on the list that we saw at the beginning of the lesson. So remember, at the beginning of the lesson, I gave you some verbs and then you had to translate them into French. And now, obviously, I thought it would be interesting to keep these verbs. So that's the reason why I told you, try to keep them in mind. And now I would like you to give me, well, the past participle. So if you're really brave, you can give me the infinitive and then the past participle of the verb. D'accord? Allez, premier, remember how it was. So to say, we've been covering these verbs. Give me the infinitive and the past participle of to say in French. Bassam, I don't understand something from you. What do you want to say exactly? Because I'm speaking in English now. Alors oui, hein, pas de problème, so it's quite clear. So the verb that we had was dire, remember. And so this participe passé will be the second part that we will use for all the compound tenses. D'accord? So it means that in that case, the past participle of dire is dit. D'accord? Allez, let's have a look now at the second one. The second one was to get, remember. Give me, please, the infinitive and the past participle. Pardon. Merci, Luciana. Well, yeah, I had to click, and that's the thing. So remember, past participle. Thank you, Luciana. Look, this is the one, sorry. And then Ice Cube, she's just like, no, it's not necessary, Luciana. Ice Cube, she's a fighter. She wants to do it like that straight. No worries. So let's look at the verbs. So we had two verbs, remember? The first one, it was recevoir. And then the past participle for recevoir, it's a bit tricky because it's reçu. So it's extremely short. Just need to remember to put the CDI reçu if you have it on your keyboard, but it might be difficult because it's not really easy to find on other keyboards than French. And then obtenir, remember, it was the other option that I was giving you. And obtenir, because it is not from the second group, as I told you, it's from the third group, it means that it will behave like tenir. Tenir becomes tenu for the past participle, it will be exactly the same thing. Obtenir will become obtenu. D'accord? So recevoir, reçu, and then obtenir, obtenu. Allez, on continue. Numéro 3. Numéro 3, and it was to know. Remember, we had two verbs for to know. Try to give me the infinitive, and then obviously the past participle. Merci beaucoup. Alors, oui. So we agreed on the fact that we had two options. The first one was savoir. Savoir, so the past participle will be su. So it's extremely short, remember, constructed with avoir, j'ai su, so it's not really tricky otherwise. And then connaître, eh bien, will become connu. Connu will be the past participle. Same thing here, you will use it with avoir. J'ai connu cette personne, for instance. So, savoir, su, connaître, connu. D'accord? Allez, on continue. Numéro 4. Numéro 4, to think. Remember, to think, how could you put, obviously, the infinitive and then the past the past participle. Ice Cube, je détestais les irréguliers il y a longtemps. And that's the beauty about it. Hein? The beauty about it is that now you are a specialist. And this is incredible. Because you've been, I mean, of course, everyone is progressing. But, I mean, the persons that I've been with for a long time during these streams, I mean, I saw the level change. I mean, like, it's incredible. Alors, oui, c'est vrai, Yesero is offering songer. It was not really an option. Well, it's not really the first one because it tends to be used less and less, in fact, songer. But it's an option, Yesero, so it's good. So, penser was the one that was probably the best option in that case. Regular verb, so it's not really tricky. Infinitive, we saw it ends with er, first group. And then past participle, it will be accent aigu, not really tricky at all, and then you construct it with avoir, so it is really simple. Numéro 5, it was to take. Infinitive and past participle, s'il vous plaît. D'accord, pas de problème. Donc là, effectivement, le verbe, c'était prendre. So we agreed on the fact that the verb was prendre. So prendre a third group. And then, as you can see, in fact, the past participle is extremely short. It's pris. D'accord? So all the verbs that will be, in fact, based on prendre, surprendre, etc., you will, in fact, construct them exactly the same way for the past participle, surprendre, surpris, etc. So here, prendre and pris. Remember, final S not pronounced, so pris, P-R-I-S, but you don't pronounce the S. Numéro 6, remember, it was to see, so please give me the infinitive and the past participle. Alors, oui, pas de problème. So it was voir. Hein, voir, third group, as I told you. So it means that basically the past participle might be tricky. This is the case because it's extremely, extremely short and it's vu. D'accord? Voir will be conjugated with the auxiliary or the helping verb avoir. D'accord? J'ai vu. So remember, it will be V-U. Numéro 7, it was to come. Alors oui, le verbe was venir, d'accord, but then, well, in that case, I've been putting as an option the feminine. Why? It's just because as venir is used with the helping verb être, it will be, I mean, in most of the cases, you will have to put, well, quite easily, in fact, the feminine or then the plural or the feminine plural. So basically, it means that because you're using it with être, when you say je suis venu, so personally, I will use V-E-N-U, because it's the masculine form. If a woman is writing the same thing, in that case, it should be venu, V-E-N-U. You don't pronounce it, but still it should be there. D'accord? So, venu, but then it's interesting because venir, one more time, it's not because it ends with er that it belongs to the second group, but it's verbs from the third group. So, venir, venu, and keep in mind that you will use être as a helping verb. Numéro 8, to want. Alors, oui, effectivement, hein, so we agree that it was vouloir, vouloir, same thing here. Third group, so past participle will be voulu, and then if you conjugate it, you will have to use the helping verb avoir. J'ai voulu, tu as voulu, il, elle a voulu, nous avons voulu, vous avez voulu, ils ont voulu, elles ont voulu. If we're talking about the passé composé now. D'accord, so vouloir and then voulu. Allez, numéro 9, to use. « Alors, je regarde. Yep. So we had two options, remember. So utiliser was the one that most of you were offering. So utiliser, regular verb. First group, so it means that the past participle will be extremely simple. It will be utiliser just with the accent. So utiliser is using avoir as a helping verb, like most of the verbs. So j'ai utilisé. So the other option that I gave you, it was se servir de. It was another possibility. So in that case, it's servi, d'accord? So I, and then I'm putting the option of the e, because basically, as you can see, it's a pronominal verb, so it means that you will have to use être when you conjugate it in the compound tenses. So, je me suis servi de. D'accord? Je me suis servi de. And so, as you can hear, then in that case, you get to use être. Voilà. Allez, on continue avec le numéro 10. Numéro 10. Alors, c'est Cosmina qui est la première, effectivement. So, it's a regular verb. It's donner. Donner, remember, from the first group. ER, no problem. So, it means that when you put the past participle, it will be extremely simple. You will end with E, accent aigu. Donner, donner. In fact, you pronounce them exactly the same way. Same thing here. Donner, like most of the verbs, will use avoir as a helping verb, so it means that you will end up with your structure. J'ai donné, tu as donné, il, elle a donné, nous avons donné, vous avez donné, ils ont donné, elles ont donné. Alors, I can see that you're 100, you are 100, so try to click. If you arrived, you didn't have the chance to click on the like, it's now or never. It's not the best person. Ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour. Just imagine the rest of the sentence. Merci beaucoup. Alors, je regarde, je vois que vous êtes en train de chercher, vous cherchez, vous cherchez. Alors, écrivez-moi une petite phrase, que je sois heureux, merci. Est-ce que vous n'êtes pas la meilleure personne pour jouer avec Nicolas? Yesero, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour faire rire les enfants, il a l'air déprimé. C'est vrai, ah, il pourrait faire pleurer les enfants, je pense. Yesero, c'est vrai. Ce n'est pas... Alors, Mercurialman, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour te rendre malheureux, d'accord? Luciana, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour me donner un conseil d'amour. Probablement pas. Vous, Slade, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour travailler avec... pour travailler ensemble, d'accord. Cosmina Bellou, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour rendre heureux votre enfant. C'est difficile la vie, même pour les poupées. Rock, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour les enfants. Gordon, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour travailler comme entrepreneur de pompes funèbres. C'est vrai. Imaginez. Imaginez, Gordon, un homme qui vient. Bonjour, c'est moi. Shahi, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour faire du travail. Yossi, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour jouer aux cartes. Pourquoi? Ah, vous croyez qu'il montre trop facilement ses émotions? C'est un personnage très très émotionnel probablement. Sherilyn, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour devenir le premier ministre du Royaume-Uni. Yulia, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour jouer avec les enfants. Beaucoup de films d'horreur utilisent des clowns, c'est vrai. Ah bah oui, c'est vrai, c'est vrai. Rommel qui nous rejoint. Bonjour Rommel. Denora, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour reconnaître ton histoire. Curiosidades, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour animer une fête, car les clowns sont heureux. Dites non aux abus de clowns. Aïe, peut-être qu'il a eu une journée difficile, c'est possible, il a eu une journée difficile ce clown. Yann Arte, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour prendre les enfants. Omar, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour une fête avec des enfants qui ont peur, bah oui. Olga, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour aller à la plage. Ah, c'est formidable Olga. Je l'adore, j'adore votre phrase, Olga, elle est très bien. Hilary, ce n'est pas la meilleure personne pour demander de corriger ses devoirs. Ben, peut-être pas. Alors, Aditya qui nous dit bonjour, bonjour ou bon matin, très bien, c'est le matin chez vous. Allez, aujourd'hui, j'ai envie de finir ce que j'ai préparé. I want to finish the things I've been preparing. So, we had a second round of sentences, and then I'm hoping that you can translate them from English to French. Let's go for it. The first one, she thinks I'm wrong. Oh non, on va mettre quelque chose de... Voilà. Alors, Rommel, the best way is to participate. Hein, la meilleure façon, c'est de participer. Try to make the exercises with us. Faites les exercices avec nous. Alors, oui, effectivement, hein, c'est quite good. Yossi was the first one, Sherilyn, right after Vusla too. So, yeah. Yulia wants to go for the... Yeah, you can do it like that, in fact. So, I was expecting you to use this avoir tort expression, hein, to be wrong. Avoir tort. So, the opposite is avoir raison. So, in fact, Yulia, she's dancing with the expressions. She's taking avoir raison and she's putting the negative form, which is totally possible. Elle pense que je n'ai, you should conjugate your verb, ai, pas raison. D'accord? So, whether you go for elle pense que j'ai tort, which would be the first translation for that, elle pense que je n'ai pas raison. Victoria Possel pense que je me trompe. Oui, 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 oui. In certain situations, oui, oui. Victoria, ça pourrait être bon. C'est pas la première traduction qui arrive, mais en fonction du contexte, c'est possible. Omar wants to go in the same direction. And then Omar goes for the. Je me suis trompé. You've been forgetting the pronoun. Je me suis trompé. So it's not a problem. Michael, je suis équivoque. But it would not be the first thing that I would go for, Michael. But then it depends. It's always a question of context. So basically, Michael and the others, maybe you want first to go for avoir tort, which is the first translation. Or then you can do like Julia, put the negative form of the opposite. Je n'ai pas raison. And then after that, it's according to the context. Allez, numéro 2. They don't want to help us. How could you say that? In French. Alors, je regarde, oui. So in that situation, well, I guess it's difficult to go with another verb. And I'm looking at your sentences to see if you've got something that could prove that I am wrong. But then I wanted first to go with the verb vouloir, so because to want, it's vouloir in French. So after that, I'm putting the negative form. Remember, when you conjugate it in the third person of the plural, it's a bit tricky because, in fact, you will have to write it veulent. V-E-U-L-E-N-T. And this is the way it goes for the plural form. So, ils, elles, veulent. D'accord? In fact, we could go in that case for the feminine plural too. It's not a problem. So you put the negative form, ne veulent pas. And the important thing in that case was to put the pronoun nous right before the verb it is connected to. The verb is aider. Second verb, it should be definitely in the infinitive, but your pronoun should come right before. This is extremely important. So, ils ne veulent pas nous aider. This is what you've been writing. I'm looking if somebody came up with Gordon, ils ne sont pas. No, Gordon, go for vouloir. It's more like straight. I mean, it's they don't want. Ils ne veulent pas. D'accord. Well, yeah, the others, they went for the same structure. So I guess we agree on that. Be careful, Olga. Veulent. It's with E and not O. D'accord. Numéro 3. Regardez, numéro 3. So it's a question. Don't you want to come with me? Don't you want to come with me? How could you translate that? Go for it. Ice Cube, she's there. Presque 2 heures. Wow, I'm finishing the exercise. I am finishing everything I prepared this time. This is the reason why I've been removing the 1 hour and 10 minutes. I want to finish what I prepared. Alors, when we go for the questions, and especially when we have the you thing in English, we've got many options, so many roads to cover. First one, let me look. So, my options would be to use the tu in that case. We could use the vous, we agree. So, tu ne veux pas venir avec moi. I wanted to write it like that with the intonation just to show you that, in fact, and in that case, it's not formal French. And we agree you're talking to somebody that you know. You just put, I mean, the order, the normal order, and you raise your voice in the end. It means that it's a question. Obviously, Yossi went for the est-ce que. And yes, it's one good option. Est-ce que vous voulez venir avec moi? Est-ce que tu veux venir avec moi? Be careful, you see, I wanted on purpose to go for the negative form also in the question. So you would have to somehow put the negative form in your question. Cosmina went for the polite form. Vous ne voulez pas venir avec moi? So it's totally okay. Julia, be careful. Tu veux, V-E-U-X. After that, I'm looking. Luciana, est-ce que tu viens avec moi? Well, it's exactly the same concept. And we agree that, Luciana, it's quite good. But then you've been forgetting the negative form in your thing. Cheryline, est-ce que tu ne veux pas venir avec moi? Ouais. Alors, that's the thing. You know, when you start to construct it with this est-ce que, and then you put the negative form, it's totally correct. But it starts somehow to become a bit heavy. Because the concept of using this est-ce que is to try to make it lighter in a way and more easy to say. But, I mean, it's totally correct. So, pouvez-vous... Ouais, Cassandra, maybe not with the pouvez-vous pas venir avec moi. It's a bit strange in that case. Vous, Slade, vous ne voulez pas venir avec moi. Ouais, d'accord. So, we agree that for these questions, whether you stay with the tu... Or then you go with the vous, and after that you construct according to that. But it was quite good, in fact. Félicitations. Avec moi, Yossi. Yeah? Why Oui, c'était it was correct avec moi, non? Why did you I'm not sure you see. Write a bit more, I'm lost. I'm lost with your question. Sorry. Allez, numéro 4. Numéro 4, numéro 4. This one is especially for Ice Cube because we know that at that time of the day, she says, usually I haven't eaten yet. How would you say that? Alors, Cheryline, she's the first one. C'est la première, comme souvent, parce que Cheryline, elle a l'esprit compétitif. Alors, and it's exactly what I've been writing, so it's quite good too. Je ne mange pas encore. So Hilary, you go for the present. I wanted to once again go a bit in the past just to see how it would go. So we agree that the verb manger, if you put the verb manger in the passé composé form, it should be constructed with avoir. D'accord? So j'ai mangé. Obviously, I want to start to play a bit more, so I am putting first the negative form. Je n'ai pas manger. So negative form of manger. Je n'ai pas mangé. And then I want to introduce this yet concept. And remember that yet, if you want to give this yet concept, you will have to squeeze even this encore right after your pas. Je n'ai pas encore mangé. Je n'ai pas encore mangé. Remember to put it properly because it's a bit tricky in that case. We have to remember how to put the negative form when we're talking about the compound tenses. And especially in that situation, you put this adverb encore to make this yet concept. Je n'ai pas encore mangé. Hein, je ne sais pas si c'est... Est-ce que vous êtes ploum ploum? Elle ouvre le frigo. Numéro 5. Alors, in that case, I have a 10 o'clock appointment with my colleague and I would like you to put colleague in French in the feminine form, please. Alors, for the persons who are arriving, remember to click on the like. It would be extremely nice. It would please me so much. Alors, oui, ça c'est intéressant. So, the important thing here is to remember that rendez-vous in French doesn't really have any romantic connotation. So it means that in fact, un rendez-vous, you can have, you can use j'ai un rendez-vous, j'ai rendez-vous. You don't need to put even the article if you want. But then it means that it doesn't have anything romantic. It's just a meeting. So Cosmina went for une rencontre, which is totally, totally okay. So j'ai une rencontre, j'ai un rendez-vous, j'ai rendez-vous. I wanted also to show you that in fact you can drop the article. Remember, Gordon, that rendez-vous is masculine. D'accord. Donc j'ai un rendez-vous, or then j'ai rendez-vous. I'm looking at the thing. So the second thing here is Colleague, I told you that I wanted you to put, in fact, the feminine form. It only impacts the possessive. So it won't be mon collègue, because if you say mon collègue, then I understand that it's a man. If you talk about a woman, in that case, it will be ma collègue. Remember that for the possessive in French, we put the gender according to the word it is connected to. It's not related, in fact, to the gender of the person. So, ma, hein, it's just ma collègue. I'm putting the feminine because collègue is the feminine form here. When you introduce the time, I'm looking at the thing. Remember to put a with the accent, obviously, and then the time, 10 heures. J'ai rendez-vous à 10 heures avec ma collègue. J'ai rendez-vous à 10 heures avec ma collègue. It was quite good, in fact. Merci beaucoup. Ah. The door is knocking. So it means that the prince of the castle is Nicolas. Il y a des gens, si tu veux qu'on te voit. Maybe you don't. Alors, Nicolas is telling me that now it's time to stop. He is my boss and he tells me when it's time to stop. Voilà, merci beaucoup. So I guess I will have to go and cook for monsieur. Remember that this is important because in 12 days it will be the birthday of, the channel, and it will be 14 years old. My God, it goes so fast. Merci beaucoup. See you tomorrow if you want. Remember, it will be at the same time, and I don't really know how long it will last. I've been removing everything with the time thing, so we'll see. Merci beaucoup, au revoir et à bientôt.